You must be here about the buying things. You're very welcome. Wonder why old Bigfoot has decided to rear his head now of all times, huh? What a mystery. Come back soon!
Half of them ox eyes done and dusted. I'll start revving up my girl Sally and she'll chew right through them.
Hot springs here are an esteemed natural resource first utilized by the ancestors of the Shoshone further back than the books go. Mountain men exploring the area came back with tall tales of bubbling mud and steaming rivers, leading to high ridicule from their despondent comrades. It seems nature's gems were dismissed as pure delirium, but further expeditions and explorations elucidated the matter better than words ever could. The stories were real, and the beautiful, bubbling geysers were our park's very own wonder. The history of our hot springs as a hot property goes back to 1906, and one Gregoire Lacroix, a French-Canadian immigrant who staked a mining claim on the banks of this here park. What he found himself in was a spot of hot water, and much like that Archimedes fella, soon thunk of something crafty. Riverbank hot tubs were the first place his mind went, and soon folk from all over were following along. Decades later, mud ain't the only thing heating up. Turns out Mother Nature's bounty ain't half easy to make a few pennies off. But hey, what can you do? They treat me nicer than any other parasites I got, and they never forget my birthday, which is more than I can say for my tapeworm.
That's a GPS doohickey. Sensitive to a fault. And it looks like this one's kaput. Keep an eye out for more if you can.
Far out in the Ruby River Range. While you're there, drop by the outpost. Much like any other outpost, you'll be able to find notice boards, storage lockers, a boathouse, and a garage for easy access to transportation.
Looks like Mr. Bigfoot's back in the park. If you can find me any more, I'll put it in the visitor center next to the pond music and the fairy parties.
This here is what folks call Ghost Town. Although a few hundred years ago, you'd have known it as Prosperity Spring, the mining hub of Wyoming. Lovely name. But there's nothing nice about chipping away at nature's beauty for some pretty rock. Maybe hard to picture now, but the powers that be didn't always see the value in protecting a place like Golden Ridge. Instead, getting carried along in the gold rush that washed the reserve down the drain. It's hard to say how much damage the toxic metal and acid runoff did to the park. I'm relieved to say that those who could put their foot down before the elks, bears, and whatever Johnson was around got ran out of house and home. Now the town rots where it stands and the gold stays where it should.
Stegosaurus skeleton. Taurus Delight, Hunter's Poison. A mature doorstop. Call it what you will, but what you're looking at is a bona fide bone.
Here you see the tracks of my tears. One more of man's attempts to siphon away nature's bounty at a heavy cost. This railway here carried a precious cargo out of the park to be refined and sold for coin. However, it got shut down when the powers that be did the right thing for once. After the mining industry was ixnayed here at the park, we had no more need for a choo-choo or two. Now they're gone to join the rest of the metal they hauled out of here.
Seeing beetles was of no odds to me. Hell, I even kind of liked them. But after seeing what they do to my park, well, mercy died that day, Buck. Halfway done. butter my butt and call me toast. It's another moldy tree. The visitors will love it. God bless her cotton socks. I don't mind a visitor or two, though, so keep me notified. How many croaky old trees is that? About two by my count. I'm sure them visitors will be flocking from all over to see them. But the lucky buck gets it for free. Six more to go, lucky you. Three quarters through, not many more of them stinking daisies, Buck. But a hell of a lot more than Sally has mercy. That's all the telltale signs of a bark beetle infestation. I'll notify the fire department that we got an at-risk area on our hands.
Oh boy, have I got a deal for you!